I certainly believe that Italian-American identity was clearly defined in the early years of immigration, but obviously after years and years and years, it's less noticeable. And probably it's less noticeable because there's the language that is missing. And so without the language, when everybody speaks the same tongue, there are no accidents, it's not as noticeable. But I can also tell you that I think that there is a strong desire for Italians to at least identify with their heritage. How deeply they can identify, what they know about the past isn't really clear. And I think all ethnic groups that came at the turn of the century, at the turn of the 20th century in 1900, are facing the same situation. A situation where, gee, the family came 100 years ago, we don't remember much. I know a lot of families who have thrown away documentation that they had when they cleaned out their grandparents' house because they couldn't read the language. The information didn't seem important, so I said, oh, this serves no purpose, so let's just throw it away. Having said that, I think that because traditionally Italian-American families have the reputation of being close, they've always stayed in touch, and as funny as it seems, Sunday dinner is a big deal. So people go to their grandmother's house Christmas Eve, Sundays, and it's one of the things that really keeps them attached. And I think obviously one of the challenges is, how do you keep this going in the future, especially as families get dispersed across the United States? Certainly, probably for different reasons than in Italy, I think that grandchildren, great-grandchildren of the immigrants have been educated. They have a lot of flexibility, and so they don't live in the town that they grew up in because they have a chance to get better jobs. Not just a job. They don't have to leave home, but if they want the job that they were trained for, you see a lot of that. I remember, in 1976, I worked on the very first article that I was involved in about Italian Americans, an Italian American neighborhood, the Little Italy of Pittsburgh, so to speak. It's called Bloomfield, and there was an Italian parish. Part of what happened to the Italian Americans was the collision that they had with the Irish Church, so there were established Italian parishes, and the priest of this Italian parish was one of the people that I was assigned to interview. And I said, Father Oliveri, I said, what do you think about these festivals that, you know, still are part of your church? And he said, oh, gee, I think that the festivals in 10 years are going to go away. And irony, above all ironies, I think festivals are just as popular today. Do I want to say that? Maybe not just as popular, but there are a lot of Italian festivals in the Pittsburgh area. They're different. They're food festivals, there's some music, and again, I think that without the language, you're missing a certain degree of authenticity. But for as much as they can do without making, let's say, a big commitment to go back to Italy, or even more, I would say, making a big commitment to learn the language, there's this sense of being Italian. I know that in the little course that I'm involved in right now here in Italy, one of the things that I mentioned to the students was the number of families that name their children, give their children Italian names. So it wouldn't be Frank, it would be Franco. And so you see a lot of that. I don't know, I know a goodly number of people who, for whatever reason, have decided to come back to Italy to get married. Whether it's official or symbolic, just because they wanted to somehow maintain roots. I guess the other thing is, I don't know whose responsibility this is. Is it the Italian organizations like the Sons of Italy, NIEF, ISDA? But how do we backfill all that information about our heritage for younger generations? In other words, where do younger generations learn this stuff? Again, I don't think it's the university. I'm not sure who it belongs to. It's the thing that's necessary. I think there's a desire on the part of the people to want to learn more about their heritage. They don't know where to turn. And so I think that the universities and the community organizations need to talk to each other. In fact, I think that in terms of what I see as my goal or my task is to bring the university and the community together so that they can share what they've learned, what they've taught each other, and to give kids, the younger generations, some sense of what I would refer to, and this certainly isn't my invention, but a usable past, so that they'll have a way to go back and search. And I know one of the things that's strange for me is for people to say, I'm from Italy, but they don't know where. I want to help them find out where. When you talk about your family history, if there were 5 million Italian immigrants that came to the United States in the period of the Great Migration, there must be 5 million stories. And in many ways, people didn't know a lot. In many ways, people didn't want to talk about things. So I always knew I came from an Italian family. I didn't ever know the town. I knew it was in Calabria. I don't know that people knew exactly where in Calabria, how you got there. I guess one of the things I've learned in my studies lately is there's kind of this idea that when the Italians came here, they had to leave Italy, they came here, and it was like walking through the door. And once they walked through that door, Italy was forgotten. And there was kind of, for many people, no turning back or no way to find out information. So I found out about my family when I was 23 years old. And as a matter of fact, my last name is different than my father's last name. And so there's a whole story that goes along with this. But when I started going to graduate school in Italian, I had the opportunity to come to Italy, and I had the opportunity to find my family. I can tell you one thing for certain, and I think that I've suggested this to many people, many students, was even though you don't know anything about your family, if you can gather some information, if you can gather some papers, and come back to Italy and look for your family, and you find them, you will be treated like kings and queens. It's absolutely an amazing experience. And so once I finally got here, and it's something my father didn't want to talk about. There's a whole family history about that. But my aunt, for some reason, was the one person in the family that saved all the information. She had some names she gave me. I came to Italy. I got on a train. I came to Amantea. I went to a hotel, took my suitcase into the hotel, called my cousins, and they were outraged that I was in a hotel. And 3 minutes later, one of the young boys came on a motorino with with my big suitcase on the motorino. He took me back to his mother's house, and we ate, and I stayed there. And ever since that day, it's been absolutely a fantastic experience. I didn't realize this when I got here this time. There was an 18th birthday. I wasn't aware that 18th birthdays are being in Italy, so I went to a birthday party. I've been to a baptism. I've been to a wedding. I have never, ever been to a ceremony in the United States where everything you ate was fish. So in these three celebrations, all we ate was fish, and there was a lot of it. And the celebrations took place at a restaurant about 500 steps from the sea. So it's been, you know, been quite an experience. The thing that's interesting is we email back and forth. We can send pictures back and forth. We telephone, and we're in communication. My cousins here have visited one of their brothers in the United States, and while they were visiting, we went to visit them. So I think, you know, the way I can probably best say this, and what I would encourage people to do, is go find your long-lost cousins. That's what it's all about, finding those people and just bringing it together, especially all these young kids that speak English. It's just absolutely a mind-boggling experience, and I would encourage everybody to do that, and fear not. Get some photographs, documents that you have, and go find them. What can they do to you? You know, they can't. I'm telling you, they'll treat you great. And now you've expanded your family, you've expanded your life. And for these younger kids that are so used to traveling, you know, they're going to make friends. And it's just going to be, you know what it is? It's a matter of replugging into your Italian heritage. That's exactly what it is. And it's very, 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 very satisfying. And I would highly recommend it. I can tell you that you can imagine the apprehensions. How do I get there? Where do you park your car? What does a classroom look like? What are the students like? I prepared myself to talk for 3 hours, but certainly the way that I like to teach is to kind of mediate through, talk about, and let the students themselves discover some of the conclusion about whatever the material is. And my experience so far has been absolutely delightful. I'm looking forward to this week. Last week was a little stressful at the beginning, but I think that by the time we got to the end of the week, we were on the same wavelength. Certainly, there are cultural differences. The academy works differently in Italy than it does in the United States. But that was just, you know what, if you have kids that are smart, that want to learn, whatever the differences are in the system can be overcome. So I think they're really interested. And of course, you know, one of the things that's the most amazing is I don't think there's anybody in the classroom that isn't somehow touched or affected by this immigration. They have cousins, friends, grandparents. I believe there's a young lady, there's a young man definitely was born in Canada, and I think there was a young lady was born in Canada. So there's really a lot of there's a lot of connection. And I always wonder about what do the Italians think of the Italian Americans? Why do they think I'm here? Is it a positive thing? Is it a negative thing? So this is a chance to investigate this. And I think that there's a lot of talking that can go back and forth in positive ways. And as I think I said earlier, it's really a great experience to find long-lost cousins, and to realize that your family came from someplace, you know, and to be accepted in even a larger, in a greater community. As we get to the end, I think of this video, I'd really like to re-explain. There were people that were illiterate, that didn't have any political power, that had no education, that had to leave their families. And in most cases, probably, even though they wanted to come back, they wanted to go to America and grub stake themselves, there was a possibility they weren't coming back. And these people went to America, they built a life, they built a family, they made America. And I think that my generation especially, but the second, but certainly the third, fourth generations, the generations have come, have really benefited from the sacrifices that these people have made. And it just amazes me when people aren't interested in finding out who these people were, because they bore so much strength that by us knowing currently who these people were and how strong they were, I think that can only boost our own self-image. I just really think that's important. And one of the things that I do when I talk about this idea of future generations, I usually end what I have to say about: how can you know where you're going if you don't know where you come from? And for me, it's been, you know, a great experience finding out who these people were. The other thing that I think really fascinated my students, you know, the economic situation in southern Italy, where 80% of the Italian Americans came from, is not very good right now, and it's always been very, very difficult. And without, you know, getting kind of angry about prejudice against Southern Italians, that idea of the Southern Italian as short, stupid, and lazy is an interesting stereotype. But boy, you don't see that stereotype in the Italian American community in America, because they have accomplished much, 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 and that's our heritage. And so we should know our heritage and what we have done, sacrifices we've made, and most important, where those sacrifices could take us in the generations to come. Certainly, I think a lot of suppositions about what happens to ethnic groups as they are further and further removed from the original immigrants. The year of the most immigrants from Italy to the United States was 1907. That's, you know, just a scotch over 100 years. I think naturally you would expect there would be assimilation into American society. Those traces, you know, would be, you know, very thin and probably sooner or later disappear. And, you know, certainly we see some disappearance of this. We see intermarriage. We see people not having any remembrance. We see people just saying, look, that was a long time ago. I have Italian last name, but it doesn't really mean anything to me. It's hard enough to make your way, and so I don't need that kind of baggage. Having said that, We also see people who are very very interested in this, and I think that I certainly encourage, let's say if you talk about the idea of a mixed marriage, so if there is an Irish-Italian couple, I think they should actually do research on both sides of it, whatever the circumstances are. Well, however many different ethnic groups are mixed, it's just a good idea to say, look, let's just flesh this out a little bit, see where we're came from, and realize that, above all, we're human beings, and we belong to this condition where things change, people move, there are intermarriages and all kinds of different intermixes. So I think there's a bright future for this, and I really like the idea. This is an image, so there's no doubt that whether it was on the part of the Italians or not might not be clear. But certainly, when the Italians and ethnic groups came to America, there was the idea of, look, we need to involve ourselves in the melting pot theory. So let's just take everybody and throw them together, and the end result is we're going to make America. And so that was the image. I much prefer the image of the American mosaic, where everybody can keep their own identity, but you have a beautiful picture made of wonderful little pieces of different colors and different shapes, and that's what America is. And I think that certainly one of the strengths of America over the years has been this idea that we understand diversity, and we can do a lot of things because we draw on people from all over the world, their abilities, their vision of the world, their different religions, and I think that really is a pretty strong power base. So that's kind of what I'd like to see happen. Having said that, the other issue is, I think that that we need to know who we are and where we came from. And so I believe that strong individuals, like strong links in a chain, make the chain stronger. Make the nation stronger. So I think this would benefit all of us. So I want us to have a better understanding, to go and do some research and to do backfilling. After 100 years, Italian Americans are third, fourth generation or more educated. They have a different kind of leisure time, so it's more than worthwhile to go back and say, let's investigate this. And of course, the other thing that we see is there's all kinds of travel. So we can, we can travel back to those countries where we came from. We can with computers and all the search tools that we have available to us today. It's really possible to find out where you came from, and you can be sure that there are some distant relative someplace. And there are going to be family stories in America about who was in Italy, and there's going to be family stories in Italy about who was in America. So to put that together, I think just enriches everybody. It's very, very fulfilling, and I think that's the direction. The academy plus the community working together to say, look, let's just get our story out there and build some kind of intellectual understanding of who we are and where we came from. And again, for all ethnic groups, not just the Italians. First thing that I will say about Italian American Studies is that I've been at it for a long time. It's 38 years that I've been somebody of interest in Italian American Studies, and I've certainly seen a lot of changes. I can remember that it seems to me there was always Italian Americana as a magazine, but the number of novels, the number of scholars, the number of conferences has just exploded. And for me, when there was never a home for Italian American Studies, the Italians thought, well, that's really kind of less than Italian. And besides that, a lot of the Italian American Studies, like 80% of the immigrants that came here during the Great Migration, came in dialect. They came illiterate, so there wasn't anything that was passed on in terms of that kind of culture. What's been for me really intriguing is the power of folklore. So when you add folklore to the equation, there's really a lot of interesting stuff to study. But at first, the Italian departments weren't really interested in that. And if certainly the English departments weren't interested. And as has been seen with a lot of the first books written, and I really have to give credit also to Melus, they have brought about a real push for the idea of taking marginalized literature, marginalized texts, marginalized cultures, and brought them to the forefront. And I think that what's happened in the last 10 or 15 years is there's an interest in, you know, kind of getting the whole story. You know, it's not a matter of telling the truth. It's not a matter of being marginalized. It's, for me, it's simply a matter of the fact that we know that the United States is a nation of immigrants. America is a country of immigrants. And so if we want to know the whole story, we need to find out who these people were. Because the fact is that it was certainly, you know, the sweat and the backs of the immigrants of the Great Migration that built the infrastructure for America. So that's been kind of delightful. And now we're seeing this. We're seeing this literature being part of regular American literature. We're seeing it being reevaluated. We're seeing people taking pride. The other thing that's kind of interesting is there's this whole new immigration that we're seeing a lot of, especially the Latino immigration. And when the Latinos come to America, from the very beginning, they have been encouraged, and they encourage their families to maintain the language, to maintain the culture. So this has all been positive stuff, serving their needs and also serving the needs of people who want to look back into the past of their Italian-American heritage or any of the heritages that come from Southern and Eastern Europe. So there are more conferences, there are more magazines. There's just a lot going on, I think, in, let's just call it, ethnic studies. And for me, the real dream is to put all of this together under the title of American Studies. That's the real story. So as much as I want to celebrate, let's say, Italian-American culture, Italian-American literature, it's really part of the greater canon. And when I say canon, I think I mean canon in terms of every kind of art of what America really is. So in a sense, we want to throw away you know, the little boxes of Italian-American literature, Italian-American culture, and make it be part of American studies. So we're going to go from the little so that we can see the big and the true picture. And I'm just really looking forward to what's going on in Italy today, because I think that really helps us. That really brings the whole picture when we have both sides studying the heritage of Italy in America. And I'd like to make some good arguments for where does American history, American literature, or Italian-American literature end, and Italian history, Italian literature begin. Because I think that the meeting point of literature about Italians outside of Italy is just as much a part of American literature, American history, as it is a part of Italian history and Italian literature. So there's a lot to come. And right now I'm involved in the first program designed to study Italian diaspora, and I think that it's just going to make the future really bright, and I think there's going to be some great exchange that's going to go on.